Already aware today, we are going to learn few of the skills on Excel as to how like Excel can be useful in our day-to-day life. But before moving on, like what Excel can do for us, I would like to briefly cover like what's the agenda of today's workshop. So like to get started with, we are going to learn about like what is MS Excel and what are its various uses. Then moving further, like how Excel can benefit in our day-to-day life, whether like we are working as a professional or we are working as a housewife or a teacher or a businessman. So you could be in any kind of profession or you could be a homemaker. Excel is very useful for each and everybody. So we are going to learn few of the tips and tricks which can be used by every one of us in our day-to-day life to make our lives easier and better. Then once we familiar ourselves with the benefits of Excel, we'll see like how we can navigate through Excel. So Excel is basically, it's a package which is being offered by Microsoft. So I'm pretty sure that everybody has heard about MS Office. One more thing which I want to ask before I move further. So is everybody comfortable with English or like, do you want me to speak in Hindi? So it would be great if I get to know the preferred mode of communication.
I think English will be a much better preferred mode, actually.
Okay, fine. May I know your good name, sir?
My name is Chandresh Chakrabarti.
Okay. Can you switch on your camera? Like it would
yeah,
be.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. Thank you.
Hi.
Hello. So like, as I just mentioned that MS Excel, it's one of the application which is being offered by Microsoft as part of their complete package of MS Office. So it's basically a spreadsheet which is being used to do various sort of calculations, right? So we are going to go through how we can navigate in Excel, what are the various rows, columns, and various functionalities available in it. Then there are some common formulas which I'll be going through today. So as to make yourself familiar, and followed by data protection, since like today we are in everything is being done online, and as you know that like as more and more things are getting online, we are getting more and more prone to cyber risk, cyber threats, and there are chances that our data may get stolen or hacked by someone. So how we can protect our data when we are using Excel spreadsheets. And then the last one is Excel offerings. So what are the various offerings which are being offered by pyramid classes as part of Excel. So moving further, uses of MS Excel, as I just mentioned that there are various uses, unlimited uses of Excel, but few of the uses I've tried to list over here. So this is not a comprehensive list, but yes, these are the few things which I think that these are the most important uses of MS Excel. So the first one is data collection and storage. So definitely Excel is generally being used as a repository to store data, to manage data. And once the data is being stored in Excel, you can process data as per your own needs. So we can do various forms of calculations in Excel. And once those calculations are done, we can analyze those results in order to understand, like in order to understand the message being reflected by those numbers. So Excel is basically used for data collection, storage, processing, analysis, calculations, as I just mentioned. Then there is one important use is data presentation. So once, let's say if there is a huge data set, so and if I have to present that data, definitely it would be very difficult for the other person to comprehend that data in the form of a huge spreadsheet. So there is a functionality available in Excel in which you can present data via charts, like with the help of charts, tables, diagrams. So there are various ways in which you can present data to the other user so that other users should be able to understand the message which you are trying to deliver through that data set. Then it is being used as a management information. So I'm pretty sure people who are from corporate background, they know that what management information is all about. And it is also used in business decisions by doing complex calculations on a daily basis. And these benefits of Excel like are, I would say, sort of derived from its uses. So since there are a lot many uses in a similar way, we have got a lot many benefits of Excel. So definitely I'm not going to go through the entire list, like how it is beneficial for each and every person, but yes, to give a brief overview, it can be, Excel is used for students, like now students are working online and they have to work on various projects. So definitely they can use Excel to make various projects with the help of by preparing charts, diagrams, all those sort of things. For teachers also, for teachers it is very beneficial. Like they can maintain the data of their students, like the marks obtained by each and every student in different tests, and they can do the grading very easily. So they don't have to perform all those calculations manually by using a calculator. Once a formula is being written in Excel, it can be the formula can be used for any number of students. So no matter whether there are 10 students or 1,000 students, the calculations can be done within a fraction of a second. Similarly, for businessmen and professionals, it's very useful. Means we can't even think of. So it depends from business to business, situation to situation, like what calculation you want to achieve or what's the problem you want to achieve. And definitely, if you understand Excel, you would be able to solve that problem very quickly with the help of this Excel spreadsheet. And for housewives, as I just mentioned that, for housewives, how it is beneficial that they can maintain the, I would say, the budget of their household expenses, like how much money they are getting. Let's say, like if someone is a homemaker, how much money they are getting from their spouse and where that money is being spent on a regular basis, to keep track of expenses. And at the end of the month or a quarter, they can analyze where most of the money has been spent. And if they want to, let's say, juggle between the expenses, they can like easily do it. Or if they want to curtail some of the expenses, it's everything is in front of them, and it would be very easy for them to decide where they want to reduce their expenditure or increase their expenditure, as the case may be. Now, this is the important part, navigation. So in case, like if I'm not very sure how much of like people who have joined today, how many people know about Excel, but when you open an Excel spreadsheet, okay, this is the way our Excel spreadsheet looks like. So in order to open Excel in your computer, we have to like go to Microsoft Office. I'll show you in case you are not aware. So Microsoft Office, since it is the application being offered by Microsoft Office, then Excel 2016. So there are various versions being released by Microsoft from time to time. So currently, like I'm using Excel 2016, but there are many people like who might be using Excel 2010. And I think last Microsoft released the new version, which is Excel 2020. So there are not major differences, but yes, since whenever a new version comes into the market, whether it is Excel or other applications, definitely there are some enhancements from the previous version. So even though if you'll be using Excel 2010 or Excel 2016, I'm pretty sure you would be able to do most of the calculations.